Trick or treat, everyone. Hopefully you had a happy Halloween. This week's blog is going to be kind of a rundown of a few different things. I'm going to talk a little bit about Halloween, a little bit about a pumpkin run and running in general, and go into our November fitness challenge. So, excuse me. Let's start off with Halloween. Candy, abundant candy is around at this time of year, and typically our clients partake in their kids' leftover candy or their candy from that they were handing out that's a little bit left over, or they pull the proverbial one for me, one for you type thing as they're handing out the candy on Halloween. We want to take the time to inform you about how many calories you could be ingesting, so you may not be looking for that candy bowl too often for the next month or 2 weeks or so. A good idea for the kids is when they go out, they get this candy, take the container from them, you know, let them have a little bit that night, and then take the container from them and ration it out over a period of time, and then get rid of the rest of the candy. It's definitely not something that they need to be taking in large quantities, and especially not over long periods of time. The average Halloween pumpkin bowl, the little trick-or-treat bowl that the little kids carry around, that typical bowl right there will hold 5,000 calories of candy. So understand that, you know, they quickly eat half that candy bowl thing. You know, you're looking at 2,500 calories. If they're carrying around this pillowcase and they get that pillowcase half full, typical pillowcase will hold 50,000. That's 50,000 calories of sugar and fat and all that other junk that's in there. So that's definitely not something you want to keep around for too long. 50,000 calories. So you got 5,000 for the little one, you got 50,000 for the big one. So just keep that in mind when you're, you know, picking out candy out of that Halloween bowl that you got, or the little dish that you've carried in for with your kids. You're definitely gonna have to work that off if you're taking in too much of that stuff. As far as working it off, pumpkin run. Just wanted to give you a little bit of update. Want to congratulate all the clients that took part and the trainers that took part in the pumpkin run. We had about 10 clients run this year, and about 10 people from Pinnacle run this year. Special congratulations to Amanda Olson and Jane Scott. Both of them finished top three in their age group. Actually, both of them finished third. Jane Scott was about 3 seconds off of the pace of the lead person in her age group. So congratulations, you guys. Did a great job. Everybody did a great job, but they especially did a great job. Basically, the race did about 1,500 runners this year. That's about 250 more than last year. So with the help of Pinnacle and everybody else, it was a successful endeavor. So we want to invite you all to come out again next year, and hopefully it'll grow even bigger. As far as running is concerned, many people have been asking me or wondering if I had heard about the Detroit Marathon. If you haven't heard, three people died during that marathon, three males, one at the age of 36, one was 65. Both those people died at about mile marker number 11. They weren't really sure if they were running a half marathon or a whole marathon, but they collapsed and ended up dying. And then another male died, age of 26, died just after finishing the half marathon. He did it in about an hour and 53 minutes, so that's a pretty good time, but it's not record pace or anything like that. But the thing about races is, it's not common for people to die. I mean, you think about how many hours they put in training and all that, and then they, you know, come to the race, and yes, they're probably pushing themselves, but it's just not a common occurrence to have cardiac arrest during a race. In fact, results show that it's about one in every 116,000 people that do a race are gonna pass away during the race. You never want somebody to die, but those are pretty good odds and pretty good. It's pretty low instances of death during something like that. So racing is generally not dangerous in that regard. Not that you're going to die. You may develop some kind of overuse injury or something like that, but definitely terminal shouldn't be the case. So our heart goes out to those people. On a different note, lighter note, and actually even a better note, a new study came out regarding diet and exercise in its regard to improvement on diabetes. Or preventative diabetes. They did a study of 3,200 adults, and since about 13% of the population now are type 1 or type 2 diabetic, they wanted to see over a long term, this study lasted 10 years, how diet and exercise would affect the instances of diabetes in overweight adults. And like I said, 3,200 adults over 10 years were followed. If they did dietary modification, decrease their calories, and did at least 150 minutes of exercise, which is about what we per week, which is about what we recommend, about 30 minutes to 45 minutes of exercise per day, four times a week, they decrease their risk of developing type 1 or type 2 diabetes by 34%. That is a statistically significant number. 34% is an amazing amount. That's a third of the people decrease their risk of, or basically prevented diabetes from occurring. So if you're borderline, or you know you have family history of it, it's definitely something you want to take part in, watching what you eat and then implementing that exercise program. Other thing I want to talk about is the November Fitness Challenge for Pinnacle. 2 months ago in September, we did the fitness challenge was the VersaClimber. I think it was actually August and September. We did the VersaClimber challenge. People come over and do the VersaClimber here, try to get as 1,200 feet as fast as they can. We had some takers on that. They did pretty good job. October Fitness Challenge was the pumpkin run. Like I said, we had about 10 people partake in that. We'd like to have a little bit more than that, but 10 people partake in that, did well. This month, again, got another challenge. This is the TRX challenge. TRX has actually instituted this challenge nationwide. You can submit a video of you doing the actual exercise, but it's a combination of the TRX atomic push-up and then the low row, separated by 1 minute of rest in between. You do as many as you can. It doesn't really matter what your number is. You know, if you are shooting to get 10, that's great. You're shooting to get 20 and 20, that's great. 30, they say 40 and 40 is championship level. I know John Greenplate completed it the other day and got like 30. So that's it's good. But the idea is to challenge yourself to get better. It doesn't really matter what you start off with. If you start off with 2, shoot for 4, shoot for 6, whatever, the second time that you do it. But I'm going to show you what the exercise, the challenge actually is, because most people, you know, wouldn't know it from Adam. So I'm going to show you the actual exercise, and if you have any questions, do ask your trainer, or you would like to do the challenge, make sure you you ask them about it. Okay, so basically what we're going to do is we're going to put our feet inside the TRX, toes in, push-up position. Just like this, push-up position. You do a push-up, bring your knees in. Push-up, bring your knees in, just like this. As many as you can do without stopping. That's a key. You cannot stop. As many as you can do without stopping. And then we're going to take a minute break. After the minute, turn your time in. 45 degrees. You're going to do low row. As many as you can do without stopping. Hands coming up to the armpit level. Just do as many as you can. That's the idea. And obviously, you want to try to get better as you go. But that's a November challenge. We'll do that from beginning November 1st all the way through to December 1st and see where you're at on that. Last thing I want to talk about, referrals. This is the time of year. Some people wait till New Year's resolutions to start an exercise program. Preventative is key. If we can prevent some of the gain that's going to occur between Halloween and New Year's, then you're starting off on the right foot. You kind of hit the ground running. Because if you're waiting after all those holidays, after the Halloween, after the Thanksgiving, holiday parties, Christmas, New Year's party, all that stuff, you could put yourself in a 5-pound hole. So we basically want to get you started, get clients started, get them started a little bit early. So this is the time to start pushing it to your family and friends. Anybody that needs to be starting an exercise program or is contemplating starting one after the new year, try to get them in. Come in. Try out. We got you Bring Your Friend to Workout Week, both the first week in November and first week in December. Both you guys get the workout for free. Person comes in and works out with you, and then you'll get the workout comps as well. We've also doing that Vegas referral challenge. Most number of referrals in the month of October, November, and December. Actually, all the way about halfway into January, to January 15th, the person that refers the most, assuming you get minimum 5, we get hotel and flight to Vegas paid for 2 people. So it's gonna be a good challenge. So I invite you to partake in that and just see how many you can get. We appreciate all the referrals, especially this time of year. And we will also be offering the typical yearly gift certificate be provided for you, complimentary. as a gift to clientele that you can give out to whoever you want. Get three personal training sessions out here at the Chesterfield location for free. So if you have any questions on any of that stuff, feel free to contact me or ask one of your trainers, and we'll see you next week.